what are these rhythms, and how do we use these rhythms in child development or in developing them?
Okay. So, we talked about the four lower senses, you remember, touch, movement, balance and life sense.
Yeah.
So, life sense gives us an idea about how comfortable we are in our own bodies. You know, sense of well-being,
yeah.
Okay, sense of wellness is the life sense. So, one of the important aspects to bring about this sense of well-being is through rhythms. The other aspects are, food and sleep and nutrition and the home environment and all of that.
Okay.
But sleep, the rhythms is a very, very important aspect, which I learned as a mother, you know, in bringing up my daughters. So, I'll just give you an example. So, when my daughters are 10 years apart. So, when my elder one was much smaller, we used to have a hard time waking her up in the morning and, getting her ready to school, and she would be like, showing so much resistance, and we had to really work hard to get her ready to school, and mornings would be such a rush and full of anxiety and tension, and run to the bus stop and send the security to stop the bus and all kinds of drama would happen, until I went to IPMT and learn about the rhythms, and I learned a lot from my younger one. She goes to a Waldorf school. I learned a lot from her teachers who told us about rhythms. So the mistake that I was making, or we were making as parents in the case of my elder one, was that we did not realize that she was not getting enough sleep.
Okay.
She would sleep very late in the night. She would watch TV till she went to sleep. We would be watching along with her, and And when a child has not had enough sleep, to wake her up too early and to rush her to school is a very, very sad and unfortunate thing.
Of course.
It's a mistake which many parents are making till today. So that's what I learned, that rhythms are so important. So what are rhythms? Rhythms are the ebb and flow of how a day goes.
Okay.
It's a sequence of activities that comes one after the other. It does not have to mean that you have to eat at this time, you have to sleep at this time. It's not like hard and fast, but once the rhythm is established, the child automatically feels hungry at a particular time, automatically feels sleepy at a certain time. You know, if you take nature, we are all products of nature,
yeah.
Like the animals and the birds and the plants. We have not been made in a factory or in a lab. Right? We are made of the same five elements that the rest of the nature is made.
Yeah.
Right? So we operate on the same principles.
Very true.
Right?
Very true.
So we feel hungry. We all feel hungry at a certain time. We all feel sleepy in the afternoon. We all, need to sleep at a particular time in the night.
Yes.
This is all pre-programmed in all of us.
It's
all
a chip
of
us, in us, yeah.
Including birds, animals, yes. And human beings. In
yes.
That aspect, we are all the same.
So something like circadian rhythms and all,
yes.
That's what...
Oh. Yeah, the biological clock, the sun rhythms,
yeah,
all that, which our ancestors used to follow. They used to follow the sun rhythm. They would wake up at daybreak, and they would wind up at the sunset.
Yes.
Because they didn't have electricity. But human beings, with all their intellectual prowess, have developed technology and developed electricity and whatnot.
It has its bones, but yeah,
yeah.
We also have
so
its...
So what we have done is we have played with rhythms, the natural rhythms.
Okay.
So rhythms are everywhere. The sun rises every day at a certain time, sets every day at a certain time. The seasons come and go in a particular way. The birds come out and they go back in the evening, and the
moon
they
has
build
rhythm.
Their nest. The moon has a rhythm, Similarly, our heartbeat,
yes.
Our breathing,
yes.
Our menstrual cycles,
yes.
Everything in us also has a rhythm.
True, very true.
So when this rhythm is in harmony with that rhythm, there is health.
That's so nice.
Right?
Yeah.
So when we are in disharmony with our own natural rhythms, we fall sick.
Yeah.
So now what are lifestyle diseases? lifestyle diseases are caused man-made, caused by us. So why more and more women are going in for IVF? Why more and more women are experiencing early menopause? More and more women are having gynecological problems, heart problems. People are getting heart attacks so early in life. You know, blood pressure, diabetes, all these are caused because we have taken our rhythms for granted.
So to flow with the rhythm is important.
It's so important.
I love that statement. We were not made in a factory.
Yeah, we were not. We've forgotten that we are part of nature.
Yes.
The same five elements are working in us, which are working in nature.
True.
You know, so we need to respect that. We need to respect that we are part of nature and nature is part of us.
Yeah, very true.
So we do night shifts, we have BPOs, we get up in the afternoon and we work till 3 in the night or morning. We just do as we please.
True.
But the body will protest somehow and the body will,
And that is strike. How it will affect the kids also. Then.
Absolutely. No? So the same lifestyle diseases that we have as adults are found in children as well. All this hyperactivity, sensory processing issues, sleep issues, behavioral issues.
Obesity.
Yeah. So many are lifestyle induced. But once you set it right and you see how the true potential of these children starts shining.
So, what is the importance of sleep here then?
Okay, so you know the rejuvenation, all the energy that we have spent in the day is rejuvenated, recycled in the night when we go to sleep.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So in the night our consciousness leaves us. So consciousness takes a lot of energy. Okay? So when we go to sleep, that's when the life forces take over and rebuild the body. So for young children, it is growth.
Yes.
For adults, it is replenishment.
Okay.
Okay. So that's why this even in diaper ads, we say, bachche neend mein badhte hain, isliye diaper pehno. Okay. So it is a fact that they grow when they sleep well.
Yeah.
You know, when they sleep well, the development is better, the growth is better. They are more balanced, they are more at ease, they are more ready to take in the challenges of the day.
One more thing that comes to my mind is, initially there were no diapers.
Yeah.
And the rhythm of the mother and the child
was
so well
innate.
Yeah. That, you know, the mother knew that the child will pee.
Yeah.
The mother knew that the child would poop.
Correct.
You know, they didn't need to check.
Absolutely.
No, so I think that rhythm also
is it's all, you know, like what we have created. So child needs about 12 hours of sleep, 12 hours of waking and 12 hours of sleep. But how much sleep do children get today? 7 hours, 6 hours, 8 hours at the most.
That's it, yeah.
You know, so before say 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, at night, before that, how much the sleep the child gets, the better it is. So the more the child sleeps between before 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. in the night, the better it is for the child's health or well-being.
Okay.
So by sleeping late, we are depriving children of that time of replenishment and growth of the etheric forces or the life forces. So the next day, the child has lesser stamina, lesser vitality.
And if then the catching the bus would be a problem.
Absolutely.
Then.
Absolutely.
Definitely.
Absolutely.
Waking them up would be a big time problem.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So what I tell my parents is that before they leave for school, they should have at least 2 hours. 2 hours, you know, for them, for us and for them to get ready at ease, at their own pace, brush at their own pace, get, you know, dress themselves up. Many times parents don't allow the children to learn self-help skills because there's no time.
Yeah, they're getting late for school.
Yeah, so kar do jaldi fatafat, you know,
brush
their teeth, put their socks on, make them wear their clothes.
Yes.
We end up doing it because there's no time. But if there was enough time in the morning, you know, suppose a child has to leave at 8, wake the child up at 6.
Yes.
For that, the child has to sleep at least till 8 to get at least 10 hours of sleep.
Yes.
For that, he has to eat at least at 7.
Yes.
You know?
So, get so those rhythms
in
place.
These are rhythms, you know.
Okay.
Healthy, natural rhythms.
And what about food here?
Yeah. So, food, again, earlier times, we used to eat before sundown.
Yes.
You know? So, even today, there are people who believe in the Vedic way of life. They eat their lunch at 12 when the sun is highest and the last meal is before the sunset. So there's enough time for digestion before they go to sleep.
Yeah.
Okay, so Steiner has, you know, people who follow, believe in this philosophy, they have given certain times. So breakfast should be before 9.
Okay.
Earlier the better. Lunch should be between 12 and 1.
Okay.
A light evening snack, a light snack, maybe a fruit or something, between 3 and 4. And dinner between 6 and 7.
Hmm.
And get ready for sleep. Create an ambience for sleep. Dim the lights. Turn off loud noises. Start speaking in soft voices. You know, just make put on a small light in the room. No frolicky activity or play before sleep. No exciting activity or play before sleep.
Yeah.
Do not expose the child to any TV or gadgets at least two hours before sleep.
Yes.
Because the electrical activity is still taking place 2 hours after you've seen something on a gadget.
Yes.
So the brain needs to come to a rest, you know, when the child is going to sleep. A child may be sleeping, but the brain is still active.
Yeah.
So, it's not fully unconscious. You know, we should be completely unconscious when we go to sleep.
Yes.
So, that when that doesn't happen, then the life forces are not able to act fully on the rejuvenation.
To replenish,
yeah.
Wonderful. So, basically, we have, best thing is, we are not factory made.
Absolutely.
We are products of nature.
Absolutely.
And just as nature follows the rules and laws of rhythms, if we are in sync with them, we stay healthy.
Yeah.
We are in a state of wellness,
yes,
rather.
Yes, yes. No? And balance.
And balance.
So, as adults, then we are well adjusted.
And we are better role models for our kids.
Better
because
human
what
beings,
we, and
yeah.
No, and what we do is what our kids are learning
so
from.
So, that's
us.
What. So, parents have to set their rhythms right.
Yes.
First. They have to think about their own rhythms. So rhythms are not just daily
so
rhythms.
So we sleeping at 12 and asking our kids to sleep by 9, we are not being a great role model there, right?
That is true. But see, sometimes maybe our work or maybe you need to catch up with your spouse or whatever. But at least we make sure the children, you know, sleep in time. And yes, definitely 12 is not healthy. At least 10 for an adult.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's easier said than done. But if we know that this is the right objective,
once we are aware, we'll start working towards it.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
We should be convinced about it.
Yes.
So conviction gives us strength to carry out these things.
Lovely.
So rhythms are not just daily rhythms, but we can have weekly rhythms, we have monthly rhythms, we have yearly rhythms. Yearly rhythms are our festivals. So, you know, it brings a sense of anticipation. You know, Vinayak Chaturthi is coming, or Janmashtami is coming, or Diwali is coming, Christmas is coming. So there's a sense of anticipation. We look forward to them.
Even the food prepared on those special occasions is very different, which is in rhythm
with the natural, with the season.
Yes.
What is available and what is warming in winter, what is cooling in summer.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
It's all been made with a lot of wisdom. You know, which we are kind of losing touch with because we don't know why it is there.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
So again, these celebrating these festivals, knowing that it will come back, gives a sense of, not only gives a sense of security for the children and a sense of grounding, but it also enhances memory. This had happened last year.
Yeah.
So it reinforces memory. It builds memory. Rhythm builds memory.
Okay.
Rhythm is a factor of memory. Memory is a factor of rhythm.
We were talking to Mrs. Nirupama Rao, and we got to know more about the anthroposophical approach to parenting and education. Keep watching and learning. Thank you.